Number four, Grant Robertson.
Thank you, Mr. Speaker. My question is to the Minister of Finance. Does he have confidence in the Governor of the Reserve Bank? If so, is he confident that the policy targets agreement he signed with the Governor in 2012 is being fulfilled?
The Honourable Stephen Joyce.
Mr. Speaker, on behalf of the Minister of Finance, yes and yes.
Supplementary question.
Supplementary question, Grant Robertson.
If he does think the agreement is being fulfilled, why did he introduce the 2% midpoint target for average inflation to that agreement, given that it has not been met for 4 years and isn't forecast to be met for another 4 years?
The Honourable Stephen Joyce.
Well, Mr. Speaker, on behalf of the Minister of Finance, the PTA meeting it is ultimately the Governor's responsibility. So over the medium term, we would expect to see inflation move back towards the middle of that band. The bank's forecast shows that happening, and the trick will be seeing that occur in practice, and that's the bank's responsibility.
Just averaging out Labor's
supplementary question, Mr.
Supplementary
Speaker.
Supplementary question, Grant Robertson.
Why will he now not revisit the overall monetary policy framework in light of his own statement, quote, "The whole framework was devised to bring inflation down. No one ever thought it would be used to lift inflation, and central banks that have tried to lift inflation have found that pretty difficult."
The Honourable Stephen Joyce.
Well, Mr. Speaker, on behalf of the Minister of Finance, I draw the member's attention to the last part of that quote that he just gave. I'd also draw the attention of him to the other quote, which has been in the last couple of days, which has indicated a bipartisan understanding of the Reserve Bank Governor's role and challenges. I quote his own leader, who said yesterday that the Reserve Bank Governor has been around in his job a lot longer than I've been in mine. He brings a lot of wisdom to his job. I accept that, yes, he's doing a good job in taking a medium-term horizon. And I think that's something that is agreed with both myself as Minister of Finance, or behalf of the Minister of Finance, and Mr. Robertson, a little out of step.
Supplementary question, Mr. Speaker.
Supplementary question, Grant Robertson.
Has he considered that what he is currently calling, quote, "unusual circumstances" with respect to low inflation might actually be the future norm, and that he should take some action to review monetary policy instead of just sitting around waiting for something to happen?
The Honourable Stephen Joyce.
Well, Mr. Speaker, on behalf of the Minister of Finance, the member should note that the inflation has been outside the target of the agreement in times in the past. For example, back in 2008, inflation was at 5.1%, which was well outside the target frame, and in that year, real wages increased just 0.1%. I'm confident that New Zealanders would prefer what we have now, which is the other way around. Real wages up 3%, inflation at 0.1%.
Question number five, Mark Mitchell.
Thank you, Mr. Speaker. My